Hello friends, welcome back to my channel tutorials.com. Today we are going to discuss about the types of force. So by now we have done force, net force and the effects of force. So what are the types of force? Now forces are of many types and based on the interaction they have, like interaction between two or more objects, they are classified as a contact force and a non-contact force. So contact forces are those in which the two or more than two objects are, they come in contact with each other. And non-contact forces are those forces in which the objects, they do not come in contact with each other. Now, how do they affect if they do not come in contact with each other? So we'll just understand that and you'll be amazed to know what sort of contact forces and non-contact forces are there. So contact force, for example, let's do the first one. So there is this ball and I'm picking this ball and I'm playing with the ball. So in this case, what force am I applying? What is the force that is pushing this ball up? My hands. So obviously I have muscles here, yes. So this muscle, it puts the ball up, high up in motion. This force that is being applied by me is a muscular force and it's a contact force. Non-contact force, I'm just summarizing it and we'll be discussing each and every force individually. Non-contact force, so this ball is falling down. Why? Which force is making this ball to go down and not up? Gravitational force. So did you see any particle like applying any sort of force on this ball? No. The force that is being applied when a ball comes down is the gravitational force. And this gravitational force, my friend, is a non-contact force. Let's just see quickly what sort of contact forces and non-contact forces we have. So first, muscular force. I already told you. Next is force of friction. Non-contact forces are the magnetic force, the electrostatic force and the gravitational force. Let's quickly summarize each one of them. Like understand what each one of them is. So I'll tell you briefly, but before that, let me quickly remind you, contact forces, interaction between two or more than two objects which come in contact. Non-contact forces, interaction between two or more than two forces, and there is no interaction, no contact, nothing, just interaction. What do you think is a unit of the magnitude of each of these forces? Now we have already studied that the unit, SI unit of force is Newton. Now, my dear, each and every force, all of these forces will have the same unit, that is Newton. So if you get electrostatic force, gravitational, magnetic, muscular, force of friction, anything, do not forget to put your N there. Now that N will give you half marks in your exams and also has a part to deduct your half marks. So it's very, 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 very important that you put your capital N there. Let's quickly see what muscular force is. So as I told you, the force that is being applied by the action of the muscles is a muscular force. Now here you can see some combats using doing some exercises. So all of these exercises collectively constitute to a muscular force. If a bull is pulling some cart, that thing is also muscular force. Any force that is being applied by using your muscles or anyone's muscles, any muscle, is a muscular force. Next, we have force of friction. So force of friction basically is responsible for changing the state of the motion of the objects. Now, what is frictional force? I have this ball. This ball is moving, but it stops. Why? It's not that my hand is too rough, but yes, because of the roughness of the surface, there is force of friction and this force of friction makes this ball to stop. This force that causes this ball to stop is force of friction. You must have seen there's so many vehicles. When you walk, you apply force. When you are writing, when I'm writing, the chalk that is writing is also, I'm able to write because of force of friction. So there are multiple tasks. Do not imagine that, you know, if this ball is stopping, this is a bad force. It's not a bad force. Not at all a bad force. We will be learning about friction. You must have already learned about friction. And you must know that this force of friction is very, very, very useful to us. And this results in many actions. Now, the force of friction is of three types. One is static, sliding and rolling. We will be learning about it in the next chapter. Let's carry forward. So these two forces, because when the ball stops, the interaction is between my hand and the ball. And when I'm playing with the ball, the interaction is between my muscles and the ball. So there is contact. And these two forces, muscular force and force of friction, are the contact forces. Next I have are the non-contact forces, where you'll not be touching the object but still causing it to cause a difference. The effect of force will be seen in the case. Now first is a magnetic force. Many times we have played with magnets, you know, a magnet and a magnetic substance, and you make it pull towards the magnet. So there you do not necessarily need to touch your magnet with the surface for the magnetic substance to move. No, you just need to show it from a distance and the magnetic substance will start to move. So in that case, the magnetic force is the force which exert a force on another magnet without being in contact with each other. The force exerted by a magnet is called the magnetic force. I hope this is clear to you. We already know south attracts north, south repels south, north repels north. Or I can summarize it by like poles, they repel each other, and the unlike poles, they attract each other. Now let's see the next one, electrostatic force. I want you to do an activity while we are at this. So you take a scale and you just rub it here like this. After you're done rubbing, like before you start rubbing, just, you know, punch a few pages, like just split them pieces, put it on the surface, put a scale, rub it like this, and put your scale on those pieces. You will see when you put the scale above the pieces of the paper pieces will start to attract it. This attraction is because of the electrostatic force. You do not need to touch the scale to the paper. You do not need to bring the paper closer to the scale. It's just the attraction which is there between the two charge. When you are rubbing it, it's charged. And when you bring it close to this, because of the induction, this also gets charged and it's attracted to the scale. So the attraction between two charged body, or one uncharged, one charge, another uncharged, either ways. So that sort of attraction or the interaction without a physical contact is the electrostatic force. I hope it's clear to you that electrostatic force is an example of a non-contact force. Magnetic force was also an example of non-contact force. Next, I have force of gravity. You must have swung on the swings, right? Like the girl that's doing here. So this is because of gravity. The ball, when it comes down, it's because of gravity. That apple that fell on the head of Newton was due to gravity. The moon that is rotating around, that is revolving around the earth, is because of gravity. If our earth, it's revolving around the sun, it's because of gravity. So gravity has a lot of uses, and this actually is the attraction between two objects which are kept at a certain distance from each other. So this attraction between two objects without physical contact is force of gravity and is an example of a non-contact force. I hope this is clear to you. One more example is simple pendulum or a girl swinging on a swing. Let's do a quick quiz. So you have to tell me, who am I? I'm a non-contact force, and the force exerted by a charged body on another charged or uncharged body. So obviously, since it's a non-contact force and it's because of the charged one, so it is an electrostatic force. I'll not write the full one because, as we can see, the writing on this thing is not fine. Next, it's a contact force, and the force which is due to the action of the muscles, it is because of the action of the muscles. Now, I told you, muscles, contact force, it's a muscular force. You know, sometimes you just have to use a trick called as and a brain and a thing called IQ. Next, it's a non-contact force, not in contact, exerted by a magnet. Since it clearly says a magnet, so the force would be a magnetic force. Very good, you're very smart. Next, it's a non-contact force and is an attraction force acting between two objects kept at a distance. So what was that which brought this ball down, or the apple on the head of the Newton? Gravitational force. So the answer to this question is the gravitational force. let's imagine that that's gravitational force, what I have written. Next, it's a contact force, and the force which acts opposite to the direction of the motion of an object. The ball was moving and it stopped. It's a contact force. The force is force of frictional or friction, or you can say frictional force as well. So either case, it's true till the see, it's science. You cannot go word by word. It's not history or anything like that. The answer needs to be correct. It's a frictional force or the force of friction. Either way, it's fine till the answer, till the time your answer is correct, it's perfectly fine. In science, specifically in physics, never forget to mention correct magnitude, correct SI units, correct formula, and what all there, what all is there which is given. Never forget that. If you even do not know the answer to a particular question, just write all these things and you'll get the correct answer. Do not worry. So let's summarize what we have just learned. There are two types of force, contact force and non-contact force. Contact forces are the forces such as a muscular force, a frictional force, and non-contact forces are magnetic force, electrostatic force and gravitational force. So muscular force is because of the muscles. Frictional force is because of when an object is moving and an opposite force is being applied by the surface on the object. Magnetic force between a magnet and a magnetic substance. Electrostatic force between two charged particles or one charged and another uncharged particle. Gravitational force between two masses kept at a distance. I hope this is clear to you. If you have any doubt, do not forget to write it in the comment section. Please do click on tutorial, subscribe it, and also check our next video so that you can learn more and grow with us. Do visit our site www.tutorial.com for more educational videos related to math and science. And also, there are certain test papers. Do not forget to log in. Thank you. Take care. Bye.